Roll call.
SP Ochoa, present.
Nereida Cantu, present.
Armin Garza, present.
Honorable Benavides, present.
Alex Cantu, present.
Mary Hernandez, present.
Dr. Sainz, I do declare quorum.
Thank you, Mr. Salinas. Can we please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
Okay, Dr. Sainz, I believe we have some public comments.
Yes, Mr. Salinas, we do have public comments. The first public comment is from Ms. San Juanita Maldonado.
Good evening, Mrs. Maldonado. You have 3 minutes. Our legal, Mr. Flores, will keep the time. He'll let you know when 1 minute is left so that you can start making closure. At no time will the board be able to address any of your concerns, okay?
Yes.
You may begin, and at
thank
the mark
you.
Of Mr. Flores.
Can I remove my mask or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Good evening, respected board members, Dr. Science, parents, and colleagues. I'm here today to advocate for our school, Leo. My name is Ms. Maldonado, and I am currently a teacher there. To me, Leo is not just an old building, it is my second home. It is a small, secure temple that means greatness to me. After a year of COVID isolation, I made the choice to come back full time last week instead of rotations, and when I did, I knew then that I was complete. This building holds my second family, people that unite together just like today to give it their all from 7:35 a.m. to 3 p.m. But then again, we don't stop there. We continue with our after-school functions. Leo was the first elementary school to introduce the great dance of folklorico. Our students' love for their culture and their identity is cultivated through this dance. Many years, our team of dancers, the Leo Drumline, Leo Jewels, Girls on the Run, Ambassadors, and the Leo Art Club have strived to be the best and represent not only Leo, but our district. Many times, they were invited to perform and compete. For example, UTRGV and the yearly teacher conference. With dedication and hard work from everyone involved, Leo was given the first art school distinction. Also important to note, Leo has been the only elementary school that has taken the students to compete in the areas previously mentioned. This is our home, where not only will it affect me as a teacher, but we have paraprofessionals, custodians, cafeteria ladies, office staff, an administration team, and most importantly, a big group of students that have found love, confidence, and a dream here at their school. I ask you today to please consider other alternatives. Alternatives such as reasoning with Flores Elementary, rezoning, and Escandon. Wait until you see transfers of faculty retirements before you make a decision. I am sure that there are plenty of other alternatives that you and your team can discuss that will benefit our Leo scholars and our school and the La Jolla ISD district. So you see, not only are you demolishing or closing a building, but you're closing and affecting our students, teachers, and staff members, dreams, foundation, and future desires to continue. Please, I ask that you take consideration in these words today.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Our next public comment is Brianna Flores, who is a student, and she will be accompanied by her mom, Juanita Flores.
Good evening, Brianna and Mrs. Flores. You'll have 3 minutes to do your public comments. Mr. Flores, our legal attorney, will keep the count on it. Once a minute is left, he'll let you know so that you can start making closure and you're able to finish off well, okay? At no time will the board address any of your concerns, okay?
Okay.
You may start it at your point.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Brianna Flores, and I was just giving the devastating news yesterday that the school I attended when I was a little girl, Leo, is going to get closed. It is with great pleasure to be here and represent Leo as a former student. I am currently at Chavez Middle School, and I am very successful thanks to the extraordinary and solid foundation given to me at Leo by my teachers. When given the opportunity at Chavez, I became a member of our school band, choir, folklorico, master of ceremony, algebra track, and in the summer I attend text prep. Besides excelling in my academics, I am faithfully involved in the fine arts department. Being a part of this team at Chavez was instilled in me since I was at Leo, because that is where we were introduced to all these extracurricular activities. Leo is a challenging school where I was allowed to be creative, expressive, and given a voice. It breaks my heart to hear it all, it will all end, but I ask of you today to please consider our feelings and of those students that are still attending Leo at the moment. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes. Good afternoon. It's I'm Brianna's mother, and I'm going to speak in Spanish for all the parents that they're over there too. Como padre, aquí estoy para apoyar a mi hija y apoyar a aquellos niños que necesitan el apoyo. Necesitan que se sientan estables en una comunidad donde se sienten apreciados y queridos. Así es como se sienten nuestros niños at Leo Elementary. Esta escuela significa mucho para nosotros y para nuestros niños, pero sobre todo para nosotros, porque yo también trabajo ahí. Yo también aporto mi dinero y también pago mis taxas y soy una madre de familia orgullosa de pertenecer aquí a la Joya ISD. No solo afectaría a las personas, sino también a muchas personas.
Le está avisando que tiene un minuto, para que vaya, tenga tiempo de acabar.
Okay. Respetamos sus decisiones en todo y en cuanto a todo, pero que sean justos y también piensen en nosotros como trabajadores y en nuestros niños. Pero sobre todo en nuestros niños, y les deseamos la mejor decisión y que nos favorezca a todos. Muchas gracias y Dios les bendiga.
Gracias, señora. Thank you, Brianna.
Gracias.
Our next public comment is Maria Nidia Benavides.
Good evening, Ms. Benavides. You will have 3 minutes. Mr. Flores, our legal will let you know when 1 minute is left so that you're able to make your closure. At no time will the board be able to answer any of your concerns at this time. So we'll be ready whenever you are. Thank you so much.
Good evening, board members and all those present. My name is Nidia Benavides, the daughter of late Rosendo Benavides. My family has been part of Sullivan City for over 70 years. My dad served the community as a business owner and school board member. For his effort and dedication, this community named a school after him, Rosendo Benavides Elementary. The school was built on land that was sold at a reasonable price, and some was also donated to help celebrate my father's achievement. It has brought great sadness and disappointment to hear that there's a discussion of the possibility to consolidate Rosendo Benavides Elementary with the two other campuses. I'm well aware of the issue with the building. However, I am also aware of the funds that have been allocated to our district by our U.S. Congress, Henry Cuellar, providing us with $160 million, which can be used to repair and improve school facilities. And this is a direct quote in which I have in writing right in front of me. I am also aware that the insurance is covering a portion, if not all of the damages at our campus building. I ask that you please consider the impact that this historical campus will have on our community. Many, many members of the district have come through Rosendo Benavides and are now well educated and hold administrative positions. We also have many students that have achieved the highest level of success as salutatorians of this great district. So in effort to make sure that I'm heard as I speak for our Sullivan City community, we are in great need of this campus, and it would be a great loss to our history. Thank you, and I hope Rosendo Benavides Elementary continues to operate. One last note. We would like to know, with the funding that I just mentioned, why would closing even be a discussion item? Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ms. Benavides.
Thank you.
Our next public comment is Janeth Cortez.
Good evening, Ms. Cortez. You have 3 minutes to do your public comment. Right behind you is our legal, Mr. Flores. He will keep track of the 3 minutes. At no time can the board address any of your concerns. You may start whenever you're ready.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Buenas tardes a todos. Mi nombre es Janet Cortés. Yo les vengo a contar de mi experiencia en Lío. Soy mamá de tres niños que han estado ahí ya 10, 11 años en la escuela. Dos de ellos han representado al folclórico con Mr. Islas. Orgullosamente de apoyarlo siempre al 100%. La escuela Lío para mí se ha convertido en mi familia, no en una escuela común y corriente como todos. Mi otra niña está devastada porque llegó llorando a la escuela diciéndome que, por favor, necesitaba de todo mi apoyo para que no se la cerrara, porque ella quiere seguir el ejemplo de sus hermanos. Para ellos, el folclórico lo es todo. Es demasiado lo que ellos están sufriendo. Más que nada mi hija Dana, que ella, su último año es el año que entra en la escuela, va para quinto. Y ella por eso no quiso venir hoy, porque se siente mal. Y es para mí como madre es doloroso ver que les quieran cerrar la escuela a mis hijos, cuando ellos, sus maestros, los tres les han tocado los mismos maestros por casualidad, y ellos los ven como su familia, como para ellos esta escuela lo es todo, y como igual para mí. Yo solo les quiero decir que consideren un poquito a los niños, porque ellos no miran su futuro en otra escuela que no sea esa, porque ellos los maestros son muy amables, muy lindos con los niños, y nos apoyan no nomás en lo de educación, sino también en lo personal. Yo he tenido mucho apoyo de ellos, siempre. Hasta ahorita yo no tengo nada de quejas de esa escuela. Para mí siempre ha sido la mejor. Gracias.
Muchas gracias, señora Cortés.
Gracias.
Our next public comment is from Rutilia Valle.
Good evening. You have 3 minutes, miss, to do your public comment.
Sí,
right,
bueno.
Behind you is... ¿Lo quiere en español?
Sí, por favor.
Okay, dispense. Señora Valle, con todo respeto, tiene 3 minutos para hacer su comentario en público. Atrás de usted está uno de nuestros abogados, el señor Flores. Él va a tomar tiempo de los 3 minutos que tiene. Cuando ya le falte un minuto, él le va a avisar para que le dé la oportunidad de acabar con los puntos que quiera anotar que tome la mesa directiva. En ningún momento en esos 3 minutos la mesa directiva puede tomar acción o puede contestarle algo de lo que usted va a presentar. Con eso, usted puede dar inicio al momento que usted guste.
Sí. Buenas tardes. Venía a apoyar que mi hija se puso a llorar porque dijo que van a cerrar la escuela. Mi niña tiene 8 años. Ahí tengo 5 años, 5 hijos, y todos mis hijos han ido a esa escuela. Tengo uno que estaba en colegio, estaba representando hasta como los inmigrantes, porque él está todo con DACA. Y Lío es una escuela muy buena, los maestros, todos los empleados que trabajan ahí. Y pues tengo a mi hija también que estuvo ahí, se va a graduar este año. Y pues quisiera que apoyaran pues si se puede apoyar para que la escuela siguiera abierta. ¿Y qué más?
Gracias.
Y espero que escuchen mis palabras y que toque corazones a cada uno de los que están aquí presentes y los que están tomando de decisión de cerrar la escuela, pues que piensen un poco en el futuro de los niños, como que ya se están a punto de graduarse, o mi hija, que es la única escuela que conoce, la más chica, es la única escuela que conoce hasta ahorita, y ella se llora y llora y me dijo: no quiero que cierren la escuela, mamá. Gracias por escucharnos a todos los padres que estamos aquí. Y es todo lo que puedo decir hasta ahorita. Muchas gracias y que Dios los bendiga a cada uno de ustedes y que les toque corazones para que tomen mejores decisiones. Gracias.
Gracias, señora. Y gracias por sus bendiciones.
Okay. Thank you. That concludes the public comments, Mr. Salinas.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Salinas. Next up, guys, is a discussion of school consolidations. I'm going to ask the board if it's possible. I think that you saw what I saw. You all heard what I heard. I would like to take this item into executive session. I would need one of you guys to make a motion in a second. And the reason being is that, I mean, you have parents, you have staff, especially you have kids coming and speaking. So with that given, if it's okay with you guys, I would like to take this item into executive session so that we can do the proper decision, because I'll tell you that what I heard right now, I'm not in favor of closing any schools. But then again, I'm only one person.
Coach, can we, before we go into executive session, have maybe somebody say, all of us, you know, speak their mind before we go?
No, that's fine.
I'll second that.
Yeah, okay. So then we go, and then when we come back, you can have the floor, or you want to speak now, and then we can go.
I'm saying for the parents that are here, they might
Okay.
So I think if we could speak right before, since they're still there.
They're still there, so that's okay.
And as for me, I know I've mentioned before in the previous work session, I've already mentioned that I'm against the closing of schools. I ask our administration to look into other avenues where we could, you know, look for where we could save. I know this has been brought up in the past, and we've been able to do it, so I ask that our administration look into it again. A los padres que nos están escuchando, que acaban de venir a hablar con nosotros, les quiero agradecer su tiempo. Y quiero que sepan, si me están escuchando, que los apoyamos, que los entendemos y que cuentan con mi apoyo, con nuestro apoyo, para seguir buscando otras maneras para poder mantener nuestras escuelas abiertas. Gracias.
Yes, and overall, I mean, our areas are growing. So, you know, we need to look at that too. There are, you know, especially like the area of Palmview and the area of Benavides, there's a lot of growth in there. There's a lot of development going in there. And overall, actually, why do we want to overcrowd our schools? I mean, we're still in an epidemic. We still need to keep that distance. So in my opinion, I mean, honestly, this is the wrong time for us to be thinking about closing schools.
Yeah.
And again, I respect everybody's opinion, but this is just the way I feel about it, okay? I appreciate you guys hearing me.
Thank you.
Well, what I'm going to say is just, you know, I know that I'm proud of La Jolla. I know we all here graduated from La Jolla. La Jolla has been our home. And I know that we're not a district of numbers. We're a district with a big heart. And honestly, it's going to take all of us to improve this situation. I understand that we have people in the community that might not have their kids in our district, but you see the impact by not doing so. So, yo personalmente le pido a toda la comunidad el apoyo para promover nuestras escuelas, porque no hay necesidad de estar en esta posición, porque todos nuestros estudiantes del área deben de estar en nuestro distrito, porque La Jolla para nosotros es el número uno y necesitamos el apoyo de cada uno de ustedes. With that being said, I will say that I'm not in favor, and I think as a district we should continue to shine bright the way we've always had. Thank you.
I know we need to be fiscal responsible, but I also know that the needs are very different and what was needed perhaps the year before pandemic and the year that now comes forward are very different. And so we need to look at different dynamics and listening to our community, listening to our students. It is with great heart that, you know, we have voice where we stand and working together and smarter. That way that we can create avenues where we can save and at the same time be fiscal responsible and making sure that our schools stay open and all the needs of our students, our staff, and most of all our community get met. Thank you.
All I would like to say is muchas gracias a todos los padres y los estudiantes que platicaron hoy en la tarde con nosotros y nada más una garantía de seguro. Que cualquier decisión que se haga con la mesa directiva, que la educación de los niños no va a sufrir, las actividades no van a sufrir, todo tiene que seguir igual. Tenemos una responsabilidad de promover todas las actividades que podamos promover para los niños, para que ellos estén bien envueltos y se desarrollen como alumnos. Pero sí queremos que todos los niños que viven en este distrito que vayan a las escuelas del distrito, porque tenemos buenas escuelas, buenos directores, buena administración y buena gente en cualquier escuela que puede proveer estas actividades para todos los niños. Nosotros como mesa directiva tenemos responsabilidad de ver todo, toda la información y hacer una decisión basado en eso. Pero muchas gracias por su tiempo, su atención, y les deseamos lo mejor con sus hijos, bastante éxito, sigan apoyándolos y aquí estamos para servirles. Gracias.
Just quickly again, we just want to reiterate that when the community speaks, we as a board, I'd like to believe we all listen. And by no means this discussion item something that we did because we don't care about the community, the schools, the people. We're proud to have each family and each employee that are represented in those schools to be part of La Jolla ISD. They make up who we are. So again, when we're listening and right now as financial stewards, it's our duty to be able to listen to this discussion, to go ahead and discuss it. But as most people said here, I mean, this is not something that we want to do. I mean, if this were to ever happen, it'd be because it's something that needs to be done. But right now, again, we just want to know that it didn't fall on deaf ears. We're here, we're listening, and we'll continue to do our best to support our community and their needs.
Thank you. I guess I know there was a motion and a second. Okay, so at this time with the motion, I'll be taking it into executive session under section codes 551071, 551072, and 551074 at 624. It is 6:50, and we are out of executive session with the item that we were pushing there. I'll pass it on to Dr. Science at this time.
Thank you, Mr. Salinas. First of all, I would like to thank all of the parents that were here this evening, attending our meeting and that chose to speak and share their thoughts. The next thing I want to say is that we do have an amazing board of trustees that is always open to listen to our community and to our parents. So I want to thank the board of trustees for working with our staff, parents, and listening to our community. The board did deliberate and did consider. One of the things that I have to say about our board also is that they are very fiscally responsible, and so it was something that they have to do, and they have to always continue to look at the district's expenses and at the same time find ways to provide the best education for our students. In our discussions, the board did, like I said, take into account all of the comments that were made from parents. And so at this time, La Jolla ISD is postponing closing schools for the next year. However, we would like to express to our community that we do have decreasing enrollment in our district. And we do need to increase our enrollment. And this has to be a community effort. We need every employee to help us recruit kids, not just for Kika de la Garza or Benavides Elementary or Leo Elementary, but for all our campuses. La Jolla ISD has the very, very best programs. We have outstanding athletics, fine arts, UIL. We have many schools of choices offering STEM, STEAM, technology, and leadership. And we ask every employee to help us recruit students for our district. The last thing that I want to say to all our parents and community is that no matter what building your child is in, we provide educational excellence for every student in every single building. And for that, I want to thank our staff, our principals, our teachers. We heard amazing things about our teachers this evening from our parents, and we want to thank all of the teachers that go above and beyond and take care of our kids, not just their academic needs, but also their social, emotional needs. So thank you so much to all our teachers and our principals. And again, thank you, Board of Trustees.
Thank you, Dr. Science. And with that being said, guys, I'll need a motion for adjournment.
So move.
I have a motion.
Second.
And a second. At this time, 6:53 meeting is adjourned. Thank you so much.